Hello friends, today we will talk on therapeutic proteins. These proteins can be used in various types of disease on the basis of genetic engineering. Protein or peptide based therapeutic agents. Peptide and proteins have immense therapeutic potential against various types of disease and genetic syndromes. They are very important part of the pharmaceutical industry and exercised in pharmaceutical industry frequently. In pharmaceutical biotechnology field, it is very valuable and important. More than 100 proteins or peptides being used and have been approved by the FDA as a therapeutic agent, and other proteins of therapeutic are under trial. Various type of recombinant proteins can be used as a biotechnology medicine like vaccine, enzyme, natural or recombinant cytokine, chemokine, interferons and antibody drug conjugates. These recombinant therapeutic proteins can be used for multiple purpose together with diagnosis, prophylaxis, immunoprophylaxis as well as immunotherapy, disease management, and the treatment of chronic disease. These therapeutic proteins effective against many fatal diseases like heart disorder, diabetes, and cancer, and other disease. Classification of therapeutic proteins. Proteins more than 100 amino acid sequence, whereas peptides are considered less than 50 amino acid linked together with peptide bonds. Therapeutic proteins categorized on the basis of their function and therapeutic application. These therapeutic proteins are classified in four groups on the basis of their property and function, that is group 1, group 2, group 3 and group 4. Classification and grouping of therapeutic proteins. Group 1, therapeutic proteins which has enzymatic or regulatory activity were classified in group 1. The therapeutic proteins classified in group 1 are further classified in group A, B and C. Replacement of deficient of normal proteins are categorized in group 1 type A category. For example, clotting factor 8 protein can be used in the treatment of hemophilia A. Group 1 type B protein. These proteins augments progressive pathway. For example, interferon alpha can be used in the treatment of hepatitis C. Group 1 type C. These proteins offer novel function or activity. For example, botulinum toxin type A or B can be used in multiple dystonia and heparin induced thrombocytopenia. Group 2 therapeutics. In this group, therapeutic proteins which has specific targeting activity classified in this group. Further, this group were classified in type A or type B. Those therapeutic proteins interfere with an organism or molecule were classified in group 2 type A category. Cetuximab monoclonal antibody can be used to treat colorectal and neck cancer. Group 2 type B therapeutic proteins. These therapeutic proteins deliver other protein or compound. For example, ibrutinib monoclonal antibody, TUZ10 and denileukin diftitox can be used in transformed non-Hodgkin's lymphoma and T-cell lymphoma. Group 3. In this group, various type of therapeutic proteins are classified which has the prophylactic activity as well as therapeutic activity. Further, this group classified in type A or type B. Type A, these proteins defense against harmful foreign agents are classified in type A. Treatment against an autoimmune disease, this type of therapeutic proteins are classified in group 3rd, type B category. Type C, those proteins being used in cancer are classified in group 3rd, type C category. For example, hepatitis B surface antigen can be used hepatitis B infection. And last, group 4th category, therapeutic proteins as a diagnostic tool are classified in group 4. Recombinant and putrefied proteins can be used in medical diagnosis. Various type of therapeutic proteins here mentioned and their use and their applications. Therapeutic proteins like factor 8, interferon, beta interleukin 1 receptor, antagonist, insulin, human growth factor, interferon alpha, interferon beta, interferon gamma, hepatitis B, and other therapeutic proteins and their applications. In hemophilia, sclerosis, autoimmune disease, diabetes mellitus, hypopituitary, dwarfism, leukemia, sclerosis, chronic granulomatous disease, hepatitis B, leukemia, respectively. Therapeutic proteins produced from the transgenic plants are listed over here. Therapeutic proteins, hirudin, epidermal growth factor, protein C, somatotropin, and other therapeutic proteins, and they are used in anti-hyper analgesic, anti-thrombotic, bound repairing, anticoagulant, growth hormone, anemia, liver, burn and surgery, and antimicrobial activity. To generate the therapeutic proteins, various type of technologies being used in recent time. Number one, protein production technology. Production of protein from transgenic animal and production of proteins from transgenic plant. Second, rational protein structure or functional technologies, that is glycoengineering, Fc fusion, albumin fusion, PEG violation, antibody drug conjugation, or monoclonal antibody chimerism. These technologies are being frequently used to development of therapeutic proteins in pharmaceutical biotechnology industry. I hope this lecture will help you to understand the therapeutic proteins and their uses. Thank you.